Hello, I'm Pastor Mark Mielig, the Caring Ministries pastor here at Calvary Church. I hope that recently you've been able to join us and follow along in the series on Galatians. Galatians is such a wonderful book to study and dig into. It's kind of like to me like a treasure chest, and once you open it, you see how many very valuable nuggets are there from God's Word. Today we're looking at chapter 5, verses 1 through 15. And in this passage, we have a revelation. A revelation, as always when we read God's Word, but a revelation specifically, insight into Paul's personality and Paul dealing with some challenging issues in the early church, as well a revelation about God and about the law that God had given them in the Old Testament. And I know that sounds like quite a bit of information, but one of the beauties of this chapter is how Paul makes it very concise. And so as we look at this today, I hope that you'll come away understanding much more about Paul and his relationships and how he handled conflict and how God had given him a revelation that simplified the truth that is being spoken there. First of all, we've heard the saying many times, keep it simple. And that's one I love. When somebody says, keep it simple, especially when it's information that I'm not familiar with, or something that's new to me, or maybe even fairly complicated. When somebody says, keep it simple, my anxiety lessens, and I'm even more in tune to what's going to be said. So with Paul here, he doesn't say, let's keep it simple, but that's what he does, is that he shares these invaluable truths in a very simple way. I don't know if you've ever received an email from someone that seemed like a couple of pages long, at least a couple of paragraphs, and how that is seems so intimidating to us. And when somebody just brings it down concisely to a few sentences, how that is a summary that we can grasp a hold of and probably even remember what they're trying to communicate to us. So Paul does that. And I know that we do that many times in our communications too, especially in music. There's a song by REM, a music group that sang Everybody Hurts was the title and the main lyrics. And that song has connected with so many people, it's actually saved lives. And so it's done simply. Let's keep this simple by saying we all hurt and what can help us when we're hurting. I love that song and it's been very popular and it exemplifies that principle that we're talking about. So as we dig into Galatians chapter 5, we're going to keep it simple here by Paul speaking into the lives of some of the early church members at Galatia. And they're struggling. There's things that they're doing that are wrong, things that Paul is clear to correct. And he does it by, first of all, in verse 1, says, "Let's for freedom that Christ has set us free, stand firm then, and do not let yourselves be burdened again by the yoke of slavery." Mark my words. Have you ever heard that before? You know somebody's trying to, again, cut down to the nitty-gritty there and clearly tell you that this is what they want you to know and what they believe strongly is. And Paul says, "I tell you that if you let yourselves be circumcised, Christ will be of no value to you at all." Boy, that got my attention. What about you? When Paul is saying this, stand firm. What does he want you to stand firm in? When Paul is saying that Christ will be of no value to you, which is just a 180 from what he really believes and has lived out in his life, what is he trying to say? He certainly gets my attention. I hope that gets yours, because what's coming up is critical to your life as a Christian and to the body of Christ. So Paul jumps into one of the issues. He's had trouble with this issue before. He even had to confront Peter about the dietary laws and restrictions of the Jewish faith. Then he comes into one about circumcision. Well, you're thinking, what could that be of help to me? But behind that, he talks about an important principle here. So let's again keep it simple. And he says that through the Spirit we eagerly await by faith the righteousness for which we hope. For in Christ Jesus neither circumcision nor uncircumcision has any value. So he's really ramping it up here. He's trying to communicate to these people, this is how strongly this truth is, that circumcision, even though it was important in your old life, now, because of the grace of Christ, that's all you need. Not ritual, how many times you get up and down during a service, not how many things you do, your works, but he's again saying how important it is for us to realize that it's Christ alone. Christ alone. We're just not used to that. We're always used to earning something or working towards something, and certainly the Jewish people were. Then he says, the only thing that counts, so mark my words here as I say this, the only thing that counts is faith expressing itself through love. He's saying love is the key here, not circumcision, dietary laws, ritual, but it's love. He even says, you were running a good race. Who cut in on you to keep you from obeying the truth? That kind of persuasion does not come from the one who calls you. Now he's calling out Satan. We know where that's coming from, and he's doing it to divide the body and to take you away from God and Jesus Christ. Then in verse 14, he goes down to again say, for the entire law, let's keep it simple, the entire law, he's going to summarize in one sentence, is fulfilled in keeping this one command, love your neighbor as yourself. Whoa, he just cleaned the whole slate here, the dry erase board, he cleaned it off and wrote in four letters the whole law, L-O-V-E. We know the greatest is to love God, and he says the second is like that, to love others as well. Pastor Bill Sisma says, Galatians 5 teaches us, just to review, keep it simple, ceremonial laws cannot make us righteous. I think we're clear on that. He was. Number two, we can nullify the power of the cross if we believe that our religious practices can enhance our standing in God's kingdom. And number three, the grace of Christ is our sole hope for salvation. And number four, demonstrating love is the most concise summary of the law. There it is for us. He's dealing with a problem. He's very forthright about it. And he comes down to say, but this is what you do need to do, because you're sidetracked. What you need to do is love others as you love yourself. I just want to close with this. In a movie that came out a few years ago was about Mr. Rogers. How many of you remember Mr. Rogers? Well, most of us have seen it growing up or have heard about it. And it just was such a simple little TV show that dealt with some very heavy issues and did with what I believe is speaking the truth from God's word, and so many examples of that, because he practiced love and he taught love and he was an example to so many people about dealing with hard issues with love. If you haven't seen that movie, I really encourage you to see it, because I know I didn't want to see it first, and my wife Susie talked me into it because I thought it's going to be an hour and a half, 2 hours of his little skits and everything. Quite the opposite. I don't want to spoil it for you, but you'll see a lot of what Paul's talking about here in that movie, Mr. Rogers. Well, God bless you, and I hope again that you'll chew on this and listen to Keeping It Simple and what Paul says, mark my words, love one another.